wearing glasses for this.
Hey there, people of the grid. It is Saturday, and today is Tesla truck update day.
That was like a month ago.
I know it was a month ago. I thought I'd let the smoke and the dust settle and let everybody vent and talk about how ugly it is and how dumb it is before I jumped in and added more stuff talking about how ugly it is and how maybe...
You're not going to say that, are you?
No.
I would.
Why don't we start, would you? Why don't we start at the beginning? So we watched the... Actually, we got invited to the event and... I was out and I got the email. I was in a meeting. I get the email. I'm like, well, I'll deal with it in an hour. I texted Tammy an hour later. Not even half an hour. I called Tammy and I said, hey, should we do this? And it was like, what, a week and a half out? Like, we only got a week and a half notice.
Yeah, something like that.
She says, yes, let's do it.
And I said,
so I respond to the email saying, we are interested in going. I'm bringing a guest, Tammy. And I got the email back, what, an hour later saying, yeah, we are putting on a hold list because we've already filled all the spots. So
that's a bummer.
If you get an invite to a Tesla event, just respond right away. Yes, I'm coming, and then deal with the
you
rest
can always
later.
Say
you yeah,
change,
like, that's what I should have done. Anyways, it was too busy of a time for us to go. So it turned out okay. And we take the money that we would have spent there.
Yeah.
We're going to spend it on Disneyland on our trip. Yeah. But you know, in watching the unveil, a couple of things stood out for me. The number one thing that stood out for me is I thought it was fake.
Yeah, I kept expecting like an Elon to pull up. Yeah. That's not really the truck.
I really see them bring out the truck and I'm like, okay, it's kind of ugly. But I'm, the first thing I was thinking was, it's not real. This is a facade. This is a fake. And he's going to do the one more thing, you know, that Steve Jobs used to do at Apple. And he's going to bring out the real Tesla truck.
Yeah, very Elon-esque, right?
Yeah. Now, that's not what happened. What happened was the truck that they brought out that was ugly and we thought was fake, that was it. That was the real truck.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just park right there for a second and think about how Tesla did this, which to me is pretty amazing because as a company, they bring out a new product, regardless of whether you like it or not. They announce...
I'm sure Elon was thinking, let's make something big and bad.
We're in Butte, Montana, and there's like some kind
football
of casino.
Game.
Oh, a football game.
It's a football game.
So they bring out this new truck, and they announce pre-orders, and you know what they got? Right now, as of, I think, early December of 2019, they had 250,000 pre-orders? Maybe 200,000. Let's say 200,000. 200,000 pre-orders. Now, if you take the lowest average selling price, let's say people buy the lowest truck, no options, and let's assume that everybody buys one. The lowest price is $69,900. We'll round down to $69,000. Multiply that by the 200,000 trucks. What do you get? What do you get?
Is
you
the
get
lowest
seven.
Price 69? I thought it was less U.S. than that.
You get $17 billion USD. $17 billion. Now, most of you will say, "Yeah, but Mike." They're not going to sell every single one of those. Not every one of those 200,000 pre-orders will go through as an order. And you're right. I agree. So let's cut it in half. Let's cut it down to 100,000 pre-orders at 69K. That takes that 17 billion down to a more reasonable 8.5 billion. I mean, let's round down. Let's call it 5 billion because let's not even give them the 50%. That's $5 billion worth of business. All they have to do is move, what, close to 100,000 trucks, which they can probably do in a three-year period from, let's say, 2021 through 2024. $5 billion. Snap your fingers. That's how much money's coming in. That's pretty amazing. The other thing that I think is really, and we'll talk about the truck itself a bit because we have a hater right here, truck hater. But what's pretty amazing is the way Tesla did the event. Like no other company these days, really, there's a few, but at this scale, they don't spend a dime on marketing. What they did do is they threw a party for, what do you think, about 3,000 people?
Not us.
Well, we could have been there, but it would have been about 3,000 people, maybe not even that much, maybe 2,000 people from around the globe, most of them from close to California, but some flew in, we would have. So 2,000 people come in. And they let a lot of those 2,000 people use things that most other companies would not let you do. Use the Tesla logo. Use pictures from the Tesla event. Put them in your blogs. Put them in your YouTube videos like I'm going to. share the message with the world. So they're getting the marketing power without spending
they're
a dime.
Using social media, which is the new marketing.
Pretty anyway. Impressive.
Yeah.
I mean, they're killing it and crushing it when it comes to using new media. They know how to do it. So they got the word out. And the other thing from a marketing perspective that I thought was pretty brilliant was when they brought out the ugly little truck and they wanted to show off a couple of things. And these are two things that I think are pretty awesome that now, actually three things. Now that I see them, I wish every vehicle had them and at least every truck had them. So they had, who's the guy, the designer guy? Franz. They had Franzi come on stage to show off how strong the glass was. He throws a steel ball into the glass of the truck. And what happens? What happens? You saw it. It breaks the window. How stupid is that, right? And then Elon says, well, let's try the back window. So he throws a rock at the back window, breaks that one too. Everybody in the world is talking about how dumb that was and how, you know, the windows aren't perfect yet.
I love the memes with like the broken windows.
There's a whole bunch. Think of the advertising distance that this got Tesla.
Yeah.
And then think about this. You ready? You ready? Think about this. You ready? When people went for the test drive, those windows were fixed. Those windows were fixed in the truck that took people on test drives. That means that they had spare glass on site. Why would you do that?
Yeah, they said they did have spare.
Hey, why would you have spare glass when you're showing off that your glass doesn't break? Because you knew that that glass was going to break, and you knew how much mileage you could get out of that through media. Every news channel on the planet. Yeah, it's very Elon Musk. He's playing everybody. But he's playing everybody because everybody was reporting and showing the truck. Like, he got so much mileage out of fake broken glass. Brilliant. Just brilliant. And not everybody caught on to it. So, number one, I love the truck. So I love Tesla stuff. When I first saw the truck, when it first rolled on stage, I thought it's fake and it's kind of ugly. It's really ugly.
Mostly we thought it was fake.
Yeah. But then on the ugly side, as I look at it more, it just got better and better looking. It was like I was having drinks and this truck was getting better and better looking all the time. I don't know what was going on. Now, today, I look at the truck at certain angles. I'm like, this thing is just awesome. It's got an aggressive stance. I like it. I like it a lot. So we put $100 down. We'll see what we do. But we do need to replace our truck. I think this is going to be our next truck.
See,
I really do.
So for me, I want to get to look more Tesla-like with the nice curves and like the aerodynamics and the sleekness. I really expected that. So when I didn't see that, I was like, well, that's not what I was looking for.
It's different.
So it doesn't look like a Tesla. It
doesn't look like anything. It looks like a low polygon render of a video game truck.
I saw this one picture of a truck drawn by Elon at age 5, and it was this truck.
You've seen the meme, yeah, Elon's truck at age 5.
But I like that it can pull, and I like that it's tough, and I am excited to see what the range is.
For the truck that we need, and the truck needs that we have,
it
meets them 100%. There's two kinds of truck owners, by the way. There's real truck owners that actually tow stuff and use it to its maximum carrying capacity, and then there's weekend warriors that like the truck styling, but they don't need a truck. Like, they rarely ever haul anything. You look in the bed of their truck and it is shiny because they haven't put a rock in there or anything. They don't need a truck. But regardless, this thing will fit the needs of both of those camps.
So I will be happy to follow that truck pulling our trailer.
You'll pull the boat with the X and I will drive that truck. You know what? I'm gonna show you a picture of my truck. I'm gonna put the Zombie 3 on it from Zombieland. I'm gonna get like a decal for the side door. That's gonna be my zombie killer truck. I love the idea. So two things I said, three actually. Let's talk about the last one, that tailgate. I don't know if you saw it. Go back if you didn't and watch the release. The tailgate that folds down and then it folds out as a ramp so you can actually drive a quad up or a motorbike up and into the back of the truck. Why haven't we seen that yet? It's going to be like the iPad. After it comes out, everybody is saying, well, why didn't we do this before? Right? So now you're going to start seeing new trucks from Dodge and Ford and Chev and everybody coming out with tailgates that have a utility function where you can use it as a ramp. It's the coolest thing. That's the third thing that I like about it. The first two that I think every vehicle should have. Where we live, we worry about hail. In the summer, we get, you know, rainstorms, and a lot of times it's a hailstorm. That damages a lot of vehicles.
Yeah.
This truck, it'll be hailproof. the glass will be hailproof. Not to mention where we live, there's also, because in the winter we get so much snow, we throw rocks on the road. We gravel the roads with tiny pebbles. Yeah, we do it on purpose to get traction. That means that everybody's windshields are broken within like 2 years, three if you're lucky.
Yeah.
So this better glass should be able to withstand that much better. So I'm excited about that. And because our Dodge Ram, it's a 1500 half ton, it's getting to the end of its serviceable life. It's like 10 years in.
It's
11.
It's older than that.
11 or 12. So
same age as Samantha, so 13.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to the Tesla truck. What are you going to say?
It is growing on me, but it just, I'm excited.
So it is growing on me.
It is growing
what
on
I
me.
What I would take was that cool ATV.
Oh, you want the ATV in the back that matches the truck? It looks pretty, yeah, it looks pretty epic. I think it's going to be pretty awesome. The other thing I like is the bed of the truck is flat. That roll down cover and then the digital rear view mirror, that's really cool stuff. I like all of that. The ability to tow our trailer, which is 10,000 pound, that's going to be killer. And the ability to throw for the first time with a truck, I'll be able to throw. I'll have to put that on my zombie truck. I'll be able to put a quad with a motorbike on one side and I think a motorbike on the other side.
You think so?
Yeah.
I don't know if
because the humps aren't an issue in that truck, whereas in the truck we have now, we have the two humps for the wheel wells. That bed doesn't have that issue because it sits higher.
Yeah.
Not to mention it's already jacked up. It's got 18 inches of clearance.
Definitely ready for the zombie apocalypse.
And that's what I need. I need a zombie killing Tesla. And now I'm going to get one. That's it for us. We are on our way to Disneyland. We thought we'd give you our thoughts on the Tesla truck. Follow along on our Disney trip. We're driving the Model X from Calgary all the way to Anaheim.
The last two legs have been a little tight. Some self-induced, some wind-induced, some weather-induced.
It's winter too. But we're here. It's going
mostly.
Good. Next time, hey, we'll take the zombie truck to Disneyland.
Oh, will
all right,
it
guys.
Hold all of us?
It sure will. Micah. And Tammy, out.
Yeah.